passionate about each other that, you know, they blog about the experience, they write about the life experiences they had. And thanks a lot, Mr. Ramendra and Mrs. Madhvi, for joining us on this particular couple show. So Mr. Ramendra is a writer, he's a speaker, you know, he does, you know, he's an author of a lot of books, 36 books he has written. And, you know, Mrs. Madhvi is a very good cook. She is a singer. And, you know, we will also get an opportunity to, you know, listen to her, you know, performance today. So thanks a lot for joining in. So, you know, the first question I have is, you know, we generally do an introduction if it's a single person, but I would request Mrs. Madhvi to introduce Mr. Ramendra and vice versa.
Okay. Let me start with his career, which has just ended for both of us. He took voluntary retirement as a general manager in Rourkela Steel Plant. He was the chief of communications there. And he opted to, you know, get out of the career because he wanted to pursue his other passion, which is writing. And he's got into this habit of writing since the age of 7. And when he was around 14, 15, he wrote his first satire. And then when he was in college, he almost got badged up because of what he had written against the fairer sex. And and then, you know, the saga continued. And somehow, even though I was also working, we somehow managed to find time for him to continue writing. So the family supported him in all ways we could. And now he's quite a prolific writer and there on most social media and, you know, in all kinds of newspapers and magazines and all. And he writes all kinds of things, you know, starting from stories for very young kids to adults and to management articles and parenting books. And so he's got and even ghazals and songs. So he's got a very wide range. So it's not as if, you know, he's restricted to one particular genre or, you know, he doesn't believe in restricting himself. Super. So that's Ramendra for you.
This is an extremely difficult task, you know, because I would need at least an hour to describe my beautiful, my gorgeous, my vivacious, my scintillating, my charming, my enticing.
He's always like this, is it?
Madhavi. As possibly later, if you give me a chance, I would tell you that how I fell in love with her. But she's amazingly left-brained, you know, very rational in thinking. She's great with numbers and analytics and all that. And I'm completely a big dumbass as far as these things are concerned. I think that's how we match. And she's got an uncanny ability to find those small faults in me. Uncanny. So I dare not try to pull a fast one on her. But yes, I'm her greatest, greatest fan, admirer. And what should I say? I'm as much in love with her now as I was on October 23rd, 1986, when I fell in love with her at 11 o'clock.
Oh, wow. You're very specific with time. Yeah, this is superb. So I have, I'm actually displaying the wedding picture of yours. So can you talk about the story around the wedding? And, you know, I've read the blog. It's just awesome. So kya hua tha?
So we both joined as management trainees in 1986. We had to go for a medical examination in our Rourkela steel plant so that they could make sure that we are not orangutans. We are human beings. So there I was asked to to go and sit in a boardroom, in a small boardroom. And when I entered, I found a guy and a couple of girls sitting there. One girl had her back towards me. And this guy turned out to be from Hyderabad. So he said, I'm from Hyderabad. And we shook hands and all. Then this lady turned back and she said, I'm Madhvi. I'm from Hyderabad. Ravi, people say that love at first sight is not possible. I'm saying that's humbug. That's bullshit. It took me exactly 7 seconds to fall in love with Madhavi, and I thought, if this beautiful angel agrees to marry me, I'll be the happiest person in the world. It took me 7 seconds, and she's rather slow. It took her 7 months.
Ravi, a few days back, it was 6 seconds. Today it has become 7 seconds. Yeah, yeah. So I'm scared, you know, maybe as we progress, the time would, you know, go on.
Her memory is rather short, you
know. Yeah, maybe he's seen it outside, seen you outside, but you know, he was just waiting for you to turn around and give the introduction.
So it took her 7 months, and then being the devoted daughter she is, she said, I'll go and talk to my dad. Then she came back all teary-eyed and all that, you know, it's going to be very difficult. You are a North Indian, Marwadi, I'm a South Indian, Telugu Vaishnavite Brahmin. So, you know, so my father is saying you can marry any Telugu Vaishnavite Brahmin, even if he's got a tail coming out of his backside. But you can't marry a North Indian Marwadi. And there was a lot of furor, and the entire family got together and they kept almost, what should we say, accusing her of creating some kind of a situation in which her dad might, you know, commit suicide or he might just wither away and all that. So after 6-7 months of, you know, this torture, she came and told me, कि रमीन ये शादी नहीं हो सकती, मैं अपने सपनों का महल अपने पिताजी के खंडहर में खड़ा नहीं कर सकती. एंड आई वाज थिंकिंग कि दिस ब्यूटीफुल गॉर्जियस वुमन हु यूज्ड टू बी एज बबली एंड वाइवेशियस लाइक माधुरी दीक्षित इज नाउ टॉकिंग लाइक कामिनी कौशल एंड निरूपा रॉय. अभी तो कुछ होगा नहीं. So I resigned from the job and went back to Hyderabad, joined a consultancy firm. After 7-8 months, I got a letter from her that, can you meet me? I said, what do you mean, can I? I've been pretty sitting in the railway station.
For the last time, ek chance de do, Raman.
I jumped into the first train, unreserved, and went to her. So she said, okay, let's get married. I'll leave the job and look for something in Hyderabad. So I said, if you leave your parents and you leave your job, the marriage won't last. And I talked to my father from Rourkela, you know, to Hyderabad, where he was a professor. And he said, देखो बेटा, मनपसंद नौकरी तो मिल सकती है, मनपसंद छोकरी बहुत किस्मत वालों को मिलती है, अगर माधवी ने हाँ कर दी तो शादी कर लो. He made all the arrangements, we eloped and we got married. So, but the company said that you have to rejoin. So I became 2 years junior to her for 12 years. And a small place, that's
the biggest sacrifice, I think.
Everybody else. This was like, you know, I was the biggest moron on planet Earth, you know. Apni biwi se 2 years junior ho gaya. Kitna bada gadha hoga ye. When she got her first promotion, for which I was not eligible, there was one gentleman who said, congratulations and condolences to Ramin. Then somebody asked, why? Congratulations because his wife got the promotion. Condolences because he did not get the promotion. But anyway, that went on and on. Then we both retired as general managers. We made up with each other and in career terms and all. And though she's superior to me in every other aspect. Then finally, how did my father-in-law, you know, kind of reconcile or accept me as a son-in-law? I placed my 13-day-old daughter on his lap. And he, being a professor of psychology, for once he used his psychology. And he thought, anybody responsible to the extent of 50% for the production of this angel cannot be a devil. And he embraced me. And now we are best friends.
Yeah, I actually have this particular sentence on. So can you elaborate that, you know, you basically said he probably realized that one person, you know, who can basically lead to a creation of an angel cannot be a devil. But why did you say that?
Yeah, because he actually thought, no, that my daughter was looking so angelic, so pretty, so beautiful. And his daughter was anyway an angel to him till I walked in. So he thought that I was responsible for the, you know, for the production to the extent of 50% of the beautiful little princess, the new princess in his life. Definitely, I cannot be all that bad. And he deigned to accept me.
No, he hadn't seen him before we got married. He didn't meet him. He didn't even want to see him. He said that, no, it has to be a Telugu Vaishnavite Brahmin. Otherwise, I don't want to meet. I'm not here to judge any person. But I don't even want to see anybody. I just want you to get married to a Telugu Vaishnavite Brahmin. So that is why, you know, that was all his conjecture, that he thought he was the devil and all that. And that is, that is the writer in him coming out.
Okay. So the next thing is you've actually written something on Facebook, basically complimenting, you know, Madhavi ji, or 28 years of experience. I think this was a couple of years back. So, yeah, can you do you remember what you've written? 28 years of togetherness, and you know, thanks Madhavi for my eternal sweetheart and best buddy.
So there I had actually written a poem, I don't have it with me right now, where I had tried to say that, you know, the only way we can get along, you know, any couple can get along, is when they are friends. So and there I tried to make it very, very humorous, you know, that like when we go shopping, what kind of experience we have, and how she keeps correcting me in the hope of still improving me. And talking about improvement, she will tell now why she chose me.
You know, I can't be as eloquent as he is. I can't, you know, describe in so many words. But, you know, he used to keep on pestering me, you know. What did you see in me that you fell for me?
Fishing and, for compliments.
Uh-huh. So then one day I really got irritated and I said, okay, I saw a scope for a lot of improvement in you. So that is why I married you. And after that, he shut up. He never again asked me, what did you see in me and why did you get married to me? So that was the end of it. So the improvement process continues. It's still on.
So, I mean, do you feel proud to give the credit to Mrs. Madhavi for, you know, whenever somebody compliments you?
Yeah, totally. Because the reason is that I was a weirdo. There's no doubt about it. No sense of dressing. I still had those Amitabh Bachchan kind of hairstyle even in the early 90s. And also, there were a lot of rough edges. I would lose my temper at the drop of a hat, ego issues and all that. And then I was from a guy school, you know, from a boy school, HPS Begumpet and all. So I feel that it's always better to be in a co-ed school, because then you look at girls in less of a, you know, men from Mars and women from Venus, or that kind of a way and all that. So I had a lot of angularities even as far as my idea towards women was concerned, especially working women and all. She was a person who mellowed me, who really kind of refined my attitude, my taste, and also gave me a more balanced view of life as well as people, you know. But balanced view of love, I have given up.
Good one. So, you have a book which recently got published. Okay, can you talk about that? So, I have the cover page which is displayed right now for the audience.
Yeah. So, should I show the cover page?
Yeah? Yes. Yeah.
This is. So this book is about my third child. He's a Labrador. His name is Aryan. He's drop dead handsome, the coolest stud in our family, though he has a lot of competition with me and my son, but he beats us hands down. So this is about these COVID times, you know, love and laughter in the times of Corona. So this guy, all four of us, two teenagers in their 50s and two uber cool adults in their 20s, all closeted together in one single house for 99 days. This was a perfect recipe for World War III. But we guys had a blast, you know. We played Scrabble, we took out old photos, did a lot of leg pulling. She cooked some lovely, lovely stuff for us to eat. And we went back to the treasure trove of our memories, when the kids were young and they were growing up and all that. And we really, really enjoyed. For Aryan, this was the best time because he got oodles and oodles of affection, 4 or 5 times of stuff normally he got. He saw his all his family members around, cuddling him, giving him so much of love, care, attention.
And food.
And food, of course, like I mentioned. There were moments of panic also. One day at 5:30, he was looking, he was dreaming about his girlfriend. He has a live-in partner called Priyamvada.
Live-in partner.
Yeah. So that moment he heard a loud din and he rushed out into the veranda thinking that the sky has fallen on his head or the washing machine has fallen on his head. And there he found his entire family beating the hell out of steel vessels, you know. And his dad, who's the worst singer on planet Earth, even trying to belt out a memory. So this was one of the incidents which Aryan remembers in his own words. The second time was, it was twilight when his dad came out of the house in a bright yellow full shirt and a blood red mask and scared the backside of out of Aryan. He got so scared, who is this phenomena and all that. But apart from that, the message is, in the worst of times, sometimes, during the worst of times, they bring out the best in us, right? And the relationships which strengthen when the going is really, really bad are the relationships which last forever. The second thing is, man is the intruder. Nature is not the intruder. When we were under lockdown, the animals and birds came out and they were celebrating across the world, but not with violence or intrusion, but with peace and harmony. And finally, generation next should realize that planet Earth is only a kind of a gift for them. They are the custodians, not the owners. So this is what this book talks about in Aryan's own words from his point of view.
Superb, superb. Congratulations on the book. So friends, we will also share the link where you can, you know, order this particular book. It's already there on
Amazon. It's on Amazon. It's on Amazon and Flipkart. And the proceeds of the book are going to Animal Rescue Center in Bengaluru called CARE.
Oh, wow. Superb.
Yeah, so Madhvi, who gets all my royalty, is not going to get a single paisa. It's going to go to CARE.
Nini, he's talking about royalty as if it's real royalty.
Yeah, I know.
Hardly anything. And he, in his own words, he says that if we have to survive on his royalty, he can't even feed Aryan for a week, you know. So
I agree. But yeah, but so very, very generous. Very, very generous of you. So let's enter the couple challenge. Okay, are you all set?
Yeah.
Okay, you know the game and you know how to play it. You basically have
can
to point
she sing
out.
A, can she sing a song?
Yeah, let's do that. Yeah, Madhvi ji, yeah, before
she's
we start, we would love to listen
voice.
To a guzzle which was written by Ramendra, which is very unique, a very rare combination where, you know, husband is writing a guzzle and, you know, you are, you know, performing on it. So please.
Yeah, and after 32 years of life, if a husband writes a romantic ghazal, that's a great thumbs
yeah,
up for
yeah,
the marriage.
Yeah, that is
true. Otherwise, normally so you would write something about K.L. Sehgal and Mukesh, you know.
I mean, there's no music to it, so I'm just, you know,
yeah,
singing
it
out
the
like
beats.
That.
We will give the beats. Sir, and I will give the beats for it.
Yeah.
तुझे पाने से पहले कहीं मैं कौन दूँ नजरों से तुझको खींच कर पल की ऊँद लूँ तुझे पाने से पहले कहीं मैं कौन दूँ नजरों से तुझको खींच कर बल्कि मूंद लूं तुझे पाने से पहले कहीं तेरी नींद पे मेरा पहरा सपनों पे मेरा हक हो
Superb, superb, awesome. So, what is the best line you liked in this particular ghazal? One line, one sentence.
You answer.
It is that one, that particular line. Tujhse hi khud ko main fir se maang loon.
Okay, can you say that saying his eyes?
Tujhse hi khud ko fir main fir maang loon. Tujhe paane se pehle kahin main khon doon. Nazaron se tujhko kheench kar palke moond loon.
Superb. Wow. Bahut sharma rahe. He is not able to connect to
you. For once.
this has never happened before. Because she hates PDA, you know. That's...
Okay. So, you know, couple challenge game. Okay. Your first question, you know, when you fight, who says sorry first? Seriously?
Yeah, but I think, when I feel I'm wrong, I do go up and say sorry.
But
yeah.
Mostly he says sorry. Mostly.
He's wrong, so he has to say sorry.
Okay. He says sorry with an explanation or just sorry?
Oh, no, the explanation is very clear because he knows that he made a mistake.
Okay. But otherwise, who usually wins the argument?
He does, because I sort of give in.
Okay.
Yeah, I win the argument because the gift of the gab.
Who's more emotional?
He's more emotional.
Yeah,
very
you have to say it like this. Yeah, so both agree. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, who fell in love first? We know the answer, but we're still asking. Okay, so you also agree, Madhviji, okay?
Yeah, that's what he says, yeah, because it took me some time.
Who is more likely to burn the house down when they are cooking the dinner? Okay. Who is more stubborn?
And he's never cooked dinner, so my house is safe. I always keep cribbing, you know. Arre, kabhi to kuch to banao. I mean, there's some time when, you know, you should, you know, enter and do something. So,
even pandemic,
once in our life, you know.
Even pandemic couldn't make him cook.
No. He was busy writing. He was busy with the kids and all. And then they didn't want him to experiment on them. So, no, but only once in our life he had entered the kitchen. He took the advice of our neighbor's wife and, you know, he cooked a meal because I had gone out and I was just reaching that day. And we had half-cooked rice and, you know, sort of semi-cooked sabji. Then I decided it's okay for my own sake. I should not let him into the kitchen.
Incidentally, the neighbor's wife was very pretty.
Yeah. I was about to ask that. You know, itna motivation. So otherwise, who is more stubborn? Okay. So both stubborn and emotional. Very, very rare combination, right?
Yeah. Very stubborn. Very stubborn.
Okay. Who is better at managing finances at home? Okay. Who takes up more than half of their...
If I would have depended on him, we would be on the footpath.
though being from Marwadi family, this is also very rare.
And
that
she's a Brahmin. I worship Saraswati. She worships Lakshmi.
No, it's not like that. It's...
Okay, we lost you for a bit. Okay, these are wonderful questions, but yeah, feel free to ask if you have any questions, audience. Okay, just give us a second. Yes, you're back.
Just the connection, yeah.
Because she was not telling the entire truth.
That's what
even the internet couldn't bear it.
No. That is the truth. I had to learn it, you know, how to manage finances, because he was worse than me.
Yeah, I'm pathetic.
Okay, this is a tricky one. Who takes up more than their half of the bed?
Half of bed?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I do.
Okay. Who? Okay. Who is the bigger flirt?
No doubt, right?
Yeah.
How do you manage?
How do you manage, Madhvi Garu? How do you manage?
I tell him I don't care. And he knows he's totally dependent on me. He can't go anywhere. Wo jo bolte hai na, deal deke rakhe, he can go only up to that string. I mean, the length of the string.
I am a terrific incorrigible flirt. Within the first 5-6 minutes, if I don't start flirting with a pretty lady, I feel I'm going to have a brain hemorrhage.
Yeah, yeah. So I think some personalities are built like that. So
yes. And you know, he thinks I'm a fool, but he keeps practicing that on me, and yeah, he thinks I fall for that.
Okay. Anytime, you know, this is for Ramendraji. Anytime, you know, when you're meeting friends and all that, you're sitting like this. Kabhi aisa laga, you know, when you're talking something which is, you know, similar to the earlier question, like you're flirting and, you know, peeche se aisa chota sa, you know, from Madhviji saying that, you know, stop Ramendra.
No, it is not the anything peeche se and all that. She only has to give me a look like this.
Okay.
And I know that I'm crossing my limits. Main chup rahunga. I know that gaze. That gaze is like, it speaks volumes, you know. It's like, should I say, the sharpest missile ever invented by man or God. So I just freeze. And then I start singing Om Jai Jagti Share. Okay. Mentally.
So who is more likely to run late always? Matlab shaadi pe jana hai, ya office jana hai and all that. Who was always late? Okay.
You know, I have this one that I can't take so much of tension. Huh? And this guy is like, you know, wherever we have to go, you know, we have to be at least 5 minutes before time. So even when we had to come on this program, he made me sit here since 10:30, and like two good school kids, you know, we were sitting and waiting for you. So this was something which used to create so much of tension in me when we were working, because he, as usual, would do nothing. So I had to do all the work and, you know, get everything set and then get ready by 8:30 in the morning, because this guy, he would start, you know, from 7:30. 7:30 baj gaya. 7:40 ho gaya. 7:45 ho gaya. And, you know, the tension of, you know, getting ready and, I mean, trying to avoid his, you know, bhashan, speech. If I'm even
reminders, yeah.
That used to drive me crazy. You know,
she's kind of covering up.
See? No. The thing is that, you know, when we retired, that was the thing which I thought, you know, now I don't have to get up and get ready by 8:30, because office is at 9 o'clock. But 8:30 I have to, because neither this fellow will, you know, eat my head.
Punctuality is a habit. For me, punctuality is an obsession.
Right.
In the last program with you also, I was there 20 minutes early. And there was an occasion when we went to a marriage, she took 20 minutes to get dressed. We went and came back before that 20 minutes.
You know, it was one of his colleague's son's wedding. So there, this guy just goes, says hello. We hand over the gift, and that guy introduces us to the bride and bridegroom.
We eat and come back.
And then, you know, he says, ha, chalo, kha lete. I said, you don't want to meet anybody else.
Who do I meet? No pretty lady.
No.
What do I do there?
No, he's there at the point.
And then what we did, we just went, we had our food. And then he says, chale. I said, did we just come here to eat or did we come here to meet anyone? He said, me ho gaya, mil liya, sabse. And I didn't know those people very well. They were, you know, his junior colleagues in the office. So I didn't know anybody there. And this fellow, and you know, exactly 20 minutes later, we were at home. And I said that it took me such an effort to get ready, and itna hum acche se shauk se taiyar hoke gaye. And then what happens? We are back home in 20 minutes. Yeah, what a waste.
But I also agree with him. You know, there is a point there. You know, some weddings you really don't want to spend more time. You know, jana hai, formality hai.
I have this talent that if I enter a room, a hall filled with 500 people, I can spot the prettiest lady in 10 or 15 seconds.
Yeah, yeah.
Then nobody was there. And the prettiest lady is with me. So why should I not spend time with
it's
her?
High risk,
house?
This thing.
Not
right?
In that pandal.
No, no. See, Ravi, the thing is that, you know, in a place like Rourkela, any marriage you go, you're definitely, you know, you surely meet people you know, because this is a small township and, you know, everybody sort of knows everybody else. But he took me, you know, if they had said 8 o'clock in the car, we arrived there at 8:01. So now people don't come like that for marriages. Okay. So when we reach there at 8 o'clock and then what happens is there's nobody around. So he said, bas kha ke chalte. I said, can attendance dal diya, khayenge, chalenge.
It's a habit. Ask Mahatma Gandhi. It's a habit. Punctuality is a habit. To her own program where she had to sing a song, she went 20 minutes late.
No. I am not like that. I wouldn't have been like this. See, the thing is that if you have to do two things and somebody has to finish 20 things, there is a difference. You know, that...
She does 20 things, but with that concentration of 20 things, I keep gazing at her. So I'm also doing 20 things.
No, that even I don't agree.
She's getting ready and all that. I keep looking at her. So then I'm also busy.
But who is a better dancer, you know, when you're going to some of these weddings, when there are people and, you know, it is colorful, you see pretty people, who is a better dancer?
I have a blast. You should play one of my videos, you know. I still dance to Batami's Dil at the age of 57.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
I have danced in a Greek restaurant to Greek music.
Yes.
And she warned me that you will be beaten up. And then she shot the video and she loved it.
Okay. Who is more likely to deal with a spider or a lizard in the bathroom? Who takes up the challenge?
He won't go anywhere near
Seriously?
That.
Seriously?
And you would find him jumping onto the cot or the sofa and he'll say, "Hey, Madhu, dekho, dekho."
With rats. I'm scared of mice and rats. Snakes I love. She doesn't like snakes. Snakes I love.
Snakes don't come into the house, okay?
In Africa, I draped a snake. Because snakes remind me of my relatives. And mice remind me of her relatives. So I'm scared of mice.
Okay. Exactly. Who's a bigger baby when it comes to cold? Catching a cold and fever. He needs a lot of attention, is it? Huh?
Lot of attention. My God,
I love attention.
He would just start at cold and he would say, "Main na shayad mar ja raha hu. I think I have hunger for it." And I and my daughter, we just look at each other and phir chalu ho
gaya. My son is also like
and,
that.
And you know, a little bit of discomfort and it will be as if, you know, it's a big calamity and, you know, he's now on the verge of death. Big drama buzz.
Total, I agree.
Pura.
Take advantage when you get it.
Yeah.
No, it's the he takes it always. There's no take advantage kind of thing.
Who is best when it comes to giving gifts? You know, when you're going to some of these weddings and all that, you know, one person is really good. Some persons are choosy. Formality hai, yaar, ye bas ye de denge. Or some people are like, achha dena. Dena hai to achha dena. So who is best?
That both of us have. Yeah.
Okay, who's
dena
more...
Hai to achha dena hai, nahi to fir band kar.
It should be thoughtful.
That is there for both.
Who's most likely to get into a fight outside, you know, not between both of you, but outside? And what occasions do you...
Auto fellow side se cut kar leta, God, for 10 minutes I have to face it because wo to chala gaya.
Same here. High five, Ramendra ji. You're same here. Okay, who is very dramatic? Tavi, you know, all points are going to him.
Yes, I said, anything and everything he can enact and, you know, put in all.
I'm a storyteller by passion. I have to be the drama boss. And if I wasn't a drama boss, she wouldn't be with me, no.
Have you ever thought of sending him to, you know, this Big Boss show? He'll be a right fit, right?
No. He goes for storytelling festivals. Wo Big Boss wo sab mein to lad lega. Nahin, he cannot...
storytelling festivals. See, the biggest drama you have to indulge is with when you're with children,
small
no?
children.
Yeah.
Really good. And very, very unself-conscious. You know, he is in his elements.
1,100 kids for an hour I handled in Abu Dhabi.
Superb.
In a particular school.
Who is most likely to forget everyone else's birthday? You?
I can't remember. like he said, 23rd October, 11 a.m. मेरे को कुछ याद नहीं.
Who is very sweet when it comes to outsiders?
I'm sweet when it comes to outsiders of a certain gender. She's basically sweet with everybody. She's a sweet person. I'm selectively sweet.
I'm not selective. I can be, you know, the same with either.
So. But yes, for me, I have one thing. I have a great empathy for underdogs. So any underdog, man or animal, I'm for them. I'll fight for them. I'll do anything possible for them.
Super. Okay, so that really ends the challenge. So, you know, it is up to the friends, your family members, your kids to decide who did well and who was really honest in, you know, saying, you know, who's who. But, you know, we really loved it. And, you know, the final questions, because you have 32 years of marriage and, you know, you've seen ups and lows. Very rare combination where both, you know, envy each other. Are at a very good position where, you know, you've really showcased yourself in, you know, your own skill sets and, you know, still going on, you know, happily. So what is the message you got for, you know, young couples out there who are in a marriage, but, you know, wo thoda sochte hain ki, you know, ours is a bad marriage, but, you know, what is a common message? You know, are fights common? Are, you know, arguments common? Differences common? What is that message each one of you have for them?
Yeah, I'll speak first because once he starts, he won't stop. So let me finish and then he can, you know, sort of take over. Now, the only thing I would say is that we do have our arguments. I mean, I'm talking about us. We do have arguments, very, you know, vociferous arguments and this one. But then we cool down also equally fast. And then the thing is that, you know, see, because maybe we have got into this marriage out of our own choice. So it is, you know, very important for us to remember what were the things which, you know, sort of got you into that marriage about the other person. I mean, theek hai, everybody has their eccentricities, their angularities, and, you know, everybody has their moods also. But that doesn't, you know, that should not overpower your earlier whatever you had, you know, for that person. And why in the first place did you actually want to be with that person, marry that person and all. So that thing should always be, you know, there at the background. Baki sab aage, whatever comes, whatever goes, it's okay. And then you again come back to the base. So you shouldn't give up on each other just because you have a few differences. There must be a lot of things which are, you know, common to both of you and where you gel properly. So a few this way, that way, ho jate hai. Lad lena, free lad lena, uske baad then you again cool down and then that's it, fine. You again adjust. So adjustments have to be there. That kind of, you know, to compatibility doesn't come overnight. It's not like, you know, they say that, okay, this star, that star, you match the horoscopes and then two people become compatible. I don't think so.
Superb.
Now that this one is for him.
Yeah, so my message would, not message, my concern I would like to express more for the guys than the girls, because I think the girls are far more confident now than they were during our times and more aware. They're going out in the open, shoulder to shoulder, as the cliche goes. So I would say that the guy should respect the woman. Respect is a word which people don't realize. This is the number one quality a guy should have. A girl also should respect, but a guy should definitely respect. The movie Thappad, I liked it only for that reason, you know. Second thing is trust. You have to have trust in each other. If you don't trust each other, your marriage is not going to last.
Even though he keeps flirting.
Yeah, even though I keep flirting and all that. And third is, you should be friends. Friends first and foremost.
Yeah.
Husband and wife will definitely happen and will continue and all that. You should enjoy each other's company, you know. And what happens is, like in us, we have huge number of differences, not differences, but different, like opinions or different tastes, different traits, different personalities, right? And we have a lot of similarities. So my final takeaway would be, I mean, for the others, would be that celebrate the differences, enjoy the similarities, forget the rest, and have a blast.
Superb. Superb. Thank you. Thanks a lot for joining us.
Thank you.
It was wonderful having both of you on the show. Great story, wedding story. And I really like what both of you said, especially what Madhavi madam has said. You should not forget what you've promised or, you know, the purpose of your marriage where you both decided. So, you know, let it stay strong and then, you know, let it not go. You know, some of these things aate jaate rehte hain, but always remember the initial thought process or initial decision what that you've taken. So thanks a lot for the message and thank you for joining in. I really enjoyed the show. I hope you also enjoyed the show.
And yeah, really enjoyed. Actually, the first time I remember me blushing, you know, kind of blushing. So that's a new high for me now.
But you failed. You couldn't see in her eyes when she was, you know, saying that sentence. He couldn't see. You know,
I couldn't see.
Are you ready to see now? Are you ready to face her now?
Such an unnatural thing to happen to me. You know, I thought I'll be so knock-kneed, I'll fall off. But Madhi looking at me and saying, "Tumko ye, tumse wo," and all that, never. And that too in public. She shies away from PDA, public display of affection, so much, you know. You made that happen, Ravi. Thanks a ton. And congrats to you, actually.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. God bless both of you. And keep rocking and, you know, please set a message for other couples out there, you know, the way you, you know, drive each other. Thank you. Have a blessed day.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.